Well, as you can imagine, emotions are still running high here in the city. People trying to wrap their minds around this senseless crime. And the people that we spoke with today say that just saying a simple prayer or laying down just one flower at a memorial gives them a bit of solace.
A heartfelt memorial just blocks from the quiet and solemn crime scene that remains cordoned off by police tape. Mixed with many from the media, people gather, leaning on each other, shedding tears of grief. Three white crosses for those who died stand with mementos for all those who were injured. But many who came out say they don't even know the victims of this crime.
But we're all connected because Boston is unlike any other city.
Elizabeth Allen grew up in this community, working in the very area that's still locked down.
My life is here, my heart is here. So when someone attacks my home, they're not just attacking the people who were hurt, they're attacking every single person who lives in all of Boston.
It just makes you value life and how blessed you are, and how blessed we are to live every day.
As people left flowers, others wrote messages. And then there were those who just looked on, trying to hold back emotion.
I don't know, it was just hard because my sister was right there when she said she can't get out of her apartment anymore because she like saw things she doesn't want to see again.
This loving display is a reminder of the tragedy the city endured and the support from people who felt compelled to come out and see it and pray for the victims.
Just to show them that we support them, that we are Boston, we are Boston strong.
Now, as we speak, the Trinity Church, a church that's still locked out of their building because of the explosions, is at that very same memorial. They're having a brief prayer service and singing songs in memory of the victims. Reporting live in Boston, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.